Now come to cell-free DNA extraction. So that we generally call a liquid biopsy. Actually, it's a little lengthy protocol, but I'm going to show you in a very short video. So let's start with the procedure. So first we will take a 50 ml centrifuge tube in which we will add 500 microliters of proteinase K. We have a proteinase that is basically an enzyme which will degrade all the proteins, protein disulfide bonds. So we will add 500 microliters of proteinase here. After that, we have a centrifuged sample that we have already have given a spin of 16,000 G for 10 minutes. So we have a plasma and as a supernatant, and all the debris and WBCs are at the bottom. So we will not involve our WBCs with plasma as we have a supernatant that is clearly a plasma. I am going to add it in the proteinase. So I am adding 4 ml of plasma sample. So after adding plasma sample to the tube, we will give a vortex that will properly mix all the proteinase with the sample. So this is, we are doing vortexing here. So after that, we will keep this mix for 5 to 6 minutes at room temperature. After that, I'm going to add lysis buffer, that is ACL buffer. So I'm adding it 4 ml as per the protocol. So we are adding 4 ml of ACL buffer here. ACL buffer is basically a lysis buffer that will lyse all the cells, all the debris, everything in the plasma. So here we are vortexing it. We vortex it for 10 to 15 seconds so that all the lysis buffer get mixed properly with the plasma sample. So after that, we will add 5 to 6 microliters of carrier RNA to our lysate. That will basically makes the efficient binding with the silica membrane that we are going to use. So after adding carrier RNA, I'm going to vortex it. After vortexing, we will keep it in a rack, and that rack we will put inside the water bath, and the water bath temperature is 60 degrees centigrade. As you can see it in the water bath, as it marks label, you can see here 60.8 or something more or less. So after we have kept it for half an hour, after half an hour I'm going to add ACB buffer to the plasma, or we can say a lysate that we have prepared. So I'm going to add it 9 ml of ACB buffer. This ACB buffer basically contains isopropanol that precipitates all the nucleic acid and make it aggregate, as it is insoluble in isopropanol. As we all know, nucleic acids are insoluble in isopropanol and ethanol. We can use ethanol instead of isopropanol also, but in case of large volume of sample, we use isopropanol. So I'm going to vortex it. After vortexing, we keep our lysate on ice for 5 to 10 minutes. After 10 minutes, we have prepared our vacuum system. That is the vacuum system, the blue one, and we have a column Upon that, we have an extender in which we will put all the lysate. So we have put all the lysate into the column. As column is very short, so we have an extender which will take all the amount of sample in one go. And I'm just going to start our vacuum system. So this is basically an alternate of centrifugation that will, through vacuum, that will pass all the plasma through silica membrane, and it will drain out all the unwanted, and our nucleic acid will be bind with the silica membrane. As it is passing on, so after it is all finished, we are having our ACW1 and ACW2 buffers that are basically the washing buffers. So I'm waiting till it get finished. I can remove our extender as it has been done. So after it all finished, I'm having ACW1 buffer that I will add 500 microliters to it. So it goes very fast. So I'm having ACW2 buffer, and as it finishes, I'm going to add ACW2, and this is also 500 microliters. So this is ACW2, and I'm adding it as it is passing very fast. So now it is done. Now we are going to give a dry spin to our column. Dry spin is basically spinning your column at a very high speed for 2 to 3 minutes. So here I'm going to put it in another collection tube. So here it is. Now I'm going to spin. So here you can see the lid is open so that all the isopropanol ethanol gets evaporated properly, so that PCR inhibition is not there. So here it is for 3 minutes. I have done this dry spin. Now I will remove it out and we'll put our column to the final elution tube. So I will add this spin column to the elution tube. Okay. Now we will keep our this column and elution tube on heat block so that any remnants of ethanol gets evaporated. Now the last step is the elution. So 100 microliters of elution buffer, that is AVE buffer, we will add to the column. 100 microliters. So I have added. Now we will wait for 5 to 10 minutes as our column is kept at room temperature. So after this incubation, we will give a spin that will elute out our DNA. So this is also at maximum speed. We are doing it for 13,000 RPM for 1 minute. So now this is the last step we are doing here. So after 1 minute, we will have our nucleic acid that we have extracted. Thank you so much.